next parallel robot is a four bar mechanism. So this is a plane mechanism in the plane. 2D. So here the degree of freedom is 1, that means there is only one input, okay, only one input here, that means only one active joint here. So here I will see here what is our main motive here. I want to find out the position of a point P, okay, I randomly choose anywhere. So here in this case I have taken the point P is here, I want to find out its position, okay. It is very easy to find out the position. So that is not our main interest here. Of course, in this chapter our main interest is only finding out the position, but in the next chapter we will see, you know, by using this position how can we find out the remaining passive variables. For example, here if you observe how many joints are there, how many joint angles are there, theta 1, theta phi 1, phi 2, of course, you know, phi 3. Phi 3 can be find out if you know theta 1, phi 1 and phi 2. Why? The total angle, sum of the angles inside the this is how much? It will be 360 if you, you know, do all the angles, okay. So no, sorry, it is not 360. In case of a triangle it is a how much? In case of a triangle 180, okay. Here in this case it is a so we will see that property, sum of the angles, okay. So here first we need to find out the position of the P here. So how we need to find out? We deviated from this. So by finding the position of that particular point P, we can find out, you know, different constraint equation. So when, what is the meaning of the constraint equation? If you have a constraint equation, then these values are no longer independent, but they are dependent on each other. When they are dependent on each other, by giving the theta 1 value, I can able to find out the other values phi 1 and phi 2 and phi 3, okay. That is the meaning of that. So here we will see this entire process in the next chapter, but here we mainly worry about finding out the position vector by finding the TH parameters. Here in this chapter also we no need to find out the position vector, only the, you know, direct kinematics we will find out. But anyway, since we are finding out the DH parameters, we will see how to find out the this position vector. So first I will take the left side. When I take the left side, first thing is I need to identify the axis. So this is the z1 and I also fix the z0 here. This is the link 1 and this is the z2 and then this is a z3. And if I come from this right side, then it will become z1 and this is a z0, okay. And here this z1 and z0, this is a revolute joint, okay. Four bar I am not explaining because everyone is very much familiar with that. Here z1 and z0 both are perpendicular to the plane, okay. When both are perpendicular to the plane, here I will choose the x0 like this, okay, x0 like this. And then how to find out the x1? X1 can be found out by knowing the z1 comma z2. So perpendicular distance, this is z1 and this is the z2. So the perpendicular distance between these two is x1. That means it is going from here, from here to here, it is going like this, okay. And again x2, I have to find out the x2. It is the perpendicular distance between the z2 and z3. This is the z2 and this is the z3. So it is the perpendicular distance between these two. This is the x3, okay. So I found out the all the required coordinate axis here. So we need to find out the DH parameters. As usual, we need to write this table. I alpha I minus 1, A I minus 1, D I, and then theta I. Okay, this is the 1 and this is the 2. So here, what is the angle between alpha I minus 1 means alpha naught. Alpha naught is the angle between the z0 and z1. That is the 0. Why? Because both are you know, intersecting with each other, and the distance between them also zero, and di is the angle between the x naught and x1. See, this is a x naught and this is the x1. So angle between these two is theta 1, and what is the distance between these two? Distance between these two is zero. Why? Because x1 and x0 are meeting at this position. Okay, and now what is the alpha I minus alpha 1? Alpha 1 is between the z1 and z2, both are parallel here. Z2 also perpendicular to the board, 0, and the distance between these two is L1 from here to here. Okay, and then we need to consider di. Di is the, di means d2. D2 is between the, d2 is between the, you know, x1 and x2. This is x1 and that is the x2. So both are intersecting. So it is the 0, and the angle between x1 and x2. X1 and x2 is a theta 2. And here again, how you find out the angle here? We need to, this, if I extend this, we need to measure like this. Okay, we need to measure this like that, not in the opposite direction. This is not, you need to remember that. Okay, that is the actual phi 1. Okay, even though I have mentioned here, this is the phi 1, that is how we need to find out the angle between these two. That is nothing but a phi 1. Okay, you need to remember this. But in the diagram I mentioned like this, no, you know, so now I will change that. This is the phi 1. Okay, so now I need to find out the, see here, the transformation from here to, according to this table, the transformation is, you know, going from here to just, you know, just immediate point on the link to. But if I want to translate up to there, to translate up to there, I need to translate along the x-axis there. Okay, so first you multiply these two and then transfer along the x-axis. So here, the, for the first one, t 0 1, what is the value? It is only seen along the z-axis. C1 minus S1 0 0 S1 C1 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 0 1. Okay, and then 1 2 2 1 2 2, and here also there is no rotation here, only one rotation there, and then here one translation. So I can combine both together here in the, in such cases. So here what is happening? So rotation about the z, so c phi 1, I will write c phi 1, otherwise you will get confused with the c theta 1 and c phi 1. So minus s phi 1 0 0, it is a translation along the x axis, so I will write here l 1. Okay, and then s phi 1 c phi 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 0 1. Okay, so again I will write one more. What is that? 2 2 2 2 2 2 is nothing but 2 2 2 2 2 2 is simply only translation along the, you know, along the x-axis. Okay, so I will write a identity matrix, and then only in place of x I will keep L2. So after multiplying everything, finally this we have already seen in case of a 3R manipulator, I interested only on the last column. You multiply this and then that. Okay, I interested only in the last column. So you write down this matrices multiplication and you check with the last column. So for the last column, yeah, for the P point P, x equal to L1 C1 plus L2 C1 phi 1. Okay, then y equal to L2, yeah, sorry, L1 S1 plus L2 S1 phi 1. This is what we will finally get. Okay, you check with that. You pause the video, you do the all multiplication, and you check for that finally. Okay, And then this is for the left hand side. And for the right hand side, how to find out for the right hand side? Right hand side again, see, for the right hand side, if I take x naught along this, then it will become, x1. And this is an angle, we need to measure angle like this. Or if I take inside, instead I will take inside, okay, x naught, that would be convenient. X naught, then this is the angle, okay. And here, for the right side, what happens? What is the DH parameters table for the right side? I will write down here itself. DH parameters, only there is only one link, okay, alpha I minus 1, A I minus 1, and then DI, and then theta I, okay. So here only one link, okay, both are intersecting, so it is 0, and this is also 0, and this is also 0, only I have a phi 2, okay. And then I need to multiply. So what I need to do here is 0 to 1 t, and then 1 to tool. Tool. So here, what is the tool? Tool 1 to tool is nothing but a translation along the x-axis until you reach the point P. Okay, so it is only translation, there is no rotation involved, so it is a simply identity matrix, and here we will get L3, 0 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 0 1, okay. And here if you substitute this and multiply, and I interested only in the last row, so in this case what happened, again x equal to, this is for the point B, x equal to you will get L3 C phi 2, and y equal to L3 S phi 2, okay. This value you get, see, this x and y, and this x and y both are representing the same position, and we can, in that way we can find some translation or some constraint equations, okay. Why we are finding constraint equation? Why? Because here this is a degrees of freedom, 1 degree of freedom, and we have so many joint variables, but not all are active variable, only one is a active variable. So how to find out a remaining passive variable? We need to somehow make use of some constraint equation. We need to derive some constraint equation. And how we derive this constraint equation? Based on the given geometry, based on the type of the mechanism or the manipulator, we will try to derive some constraint, to try to form some loop closure equation. We call it as a loop closure equation, okay. So that means there is no hard and fast rule, so based on we can derive this based on case by case basis, okay.